absolutely beautiful.
Fast falls the eventide, the darkness deepens, Lord, with me abide. When other helpers fail and comforts flee, help of the helpless, oh, abide with me. Hold thou thy cross
Ashcroft, James Gary Aspinall, Kester Roger Marcus Ball, Gerard Barron Sr., Simon Bell, Barry Sidney Bennett, David John Benson, David William Birtle, Tony Bland, Paul David Brady, Andrew Mark Brooks, Carl Brown, David Stephen Brown, Henry Thomas Burke, Peter Andrew Burkett, Paul William Carlisle, Raymond Thomas Chapman, Gary Christopher Church, Joseph Clark.
Paul Clark, Gary Collins, Stephen Paul Kopok, Tracy Elizabeth Cox, James Philip Delaney, Christopher Barry Devonside, Christopher Edwards, Vincent Michael Fitzsimmons, Thomas Stephen Fox, John Paul Gilhooley, Barry Glover, Ian Thomas Glover, Derek George Godwin, Roy Harry Hamilton, Philip Hammond, Eric Hankin, Gary Harrison, Stephen Francis Harrison, Peter Andrew Harrison, David Hawley.
In my
James Robert Hennessy, Paul Anthony Hewitson, Carl Darren Hewitt, Nicholas Michael Hewitt, Sarah Louise Hicks, Victoria Jane Hicks, Gordon Rodney Horn, Arthur Horrocks, Thomas Howard, Thomas Anthony Howard, Eric George Hughes, Alan Johnston, Christine Ann Jones, Gary Philip Jones, Richard Jones, Nicholas Peter Joins, Anthony Peter Kelly, Michael David Kelly, Carl David Lewis, David William Mather.
Brian Christopher Matthews, Francis Joseph McAllister, John McBride, Marion Hazel McCabe, Joseph Daniel McCarthy, Peter McDonnell, Alan McClone, Keith McGrath, Paul Brian Murray, Lee Nickel, Stephen Francis O'Neill, Jonathan Owens, William Roy Pemberton, Carl William Rimmer, David George Rimmer, Graham John Roberts, Stephen Joseph Robinson, Henry Charles Rogers, Colin Andrew Hugh William Sefton, Ingar Shah.
Paula Ann Smith, Adam Edward Spirit, Philip John Steele, David Leonard Thomas, Patrick John Thompson, Peter Reuben Thompson, Stuart Paul William Thompson, Peter Francis Tootle, Christopher James Trainer, Martin Kevin Trainer, Kevin Tyrrell, Colin Wafer, Ian David Whelan, Martin Kenneth Wild, Kevin Daniel Williams. Graham John Wright.
Would you please stand? We observe 1 minute silence in remembrance and in thanksgiving. A time never to forget. Please be seated.
Merseyside is united this afternoon at a service to mark 25 years since the Hillsborough disaster. Liverpool manager Brendan Rodgers will do a reading very shortly. But these, the scenes a short time ago inside Anfield, as Liverpool fans and Everton fans inside the stadium got to their feet as Roberto Martinez, the Everton manager, made his way down to pitch side for his reading and his address to the near 30,000 people inside Anfield. What a scene that is, that the Everton manager should receive such a response. He said in the past they are shoulder to shoulder with Liverpool. Let's hear from Roberto Martinez now.
St. John, chapter 14, verses 1 to 3. Jesus said, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you up to myself, that where I am, there you may be also." I was only 15 in April 1989. Football mad kid, football mad family, like many of you today. And we heard the news. We heard about Hillsborough. And as a family, we couldn't believe the pain and horror that the families would get by receiving the news that the loved ones wouldn't be coming home. Wouldn't be coming home from a football match. How can anyone die watching the game you love? That isn't right. That isn't fair. What happened after wasn't right or fair either. To have to fight for the good name of the ones you lost was appalling. But as my chairman said a year ago, the authorities took on the wrong city if they thought they were going to get away with that.
For the city of Liverpool and the whole of football uniting to remember Hillsborough and the 96 victims. 25 years ago it happened. Let's hear from the Liverpool boss now, Brendan Rodgers.
Psalm 23, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table for me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Just before I make a few brief personal remarks, I just want to say a big thank you to Roberto for coming over. It's never easy coming over. Wonderful speech, and no matter what the clubs are doing, it shows that this city is very much together, both in people and in football. So thank you, Roberto. First and foremost, I want to thank you, the Hillsborough families, for giving me the privilege of speaking at the service today. I feel very humbled and honoured to be in your company. As manager of Liverpool Football Club, I'm surrounded every day of my life by inspiration. Every day I walk in past the statue of Bill Shankly, I also walk past the European Cup, which is obviously a trophy synonymous with winning at this great football club. We train on the same pitches, graced by the likes of St John and Yates and Callaghan and Keegan and Toshack, Dalglish, Rush, Barnes, all the great names, and I could go on forever talking about them. Within my current team, I have some fantastic players of true greatness, playing great football, and are right now wearing their famous red jersey. You don't really struggle for inspiration when you're Liverpool manager, when you work for this great football club. But without doubt, the single biggest source of inspiration for me is every match day here at Anfield. When I arrive at the ground and I see the Hillsborough Memorial, where I see 96 names. 96 individuals that were all loved, cherished, and all went too soon. Those who we lost, and for those of you who have fought and campaigned tirelessly on their behalf, and on behalf of the survivors, you are the real true inspiration for us. Mothers and fathers, brothers and sisters, sons and daughters, friends and fellow supporters, you've all stood for 25 years together to honour and fight for the 96 people we lost. Your courage, your fortitude, your resilience, your dignity, and your love for the people you lost, that's what inspires me every single day of my life as the manager of Liverpool Football Club. In becoming the manager of such a great club, you're privileged to follow in the footsteps of great men and great people. And although you aspire to live up to them one day, you know that that's impossible. One such man is with us today, which is Kenny Dalglish. Liverpool Football Club in the city of Liverpool was so blessed to have a man of his qualities leading the club at such a time of darkness. And although he personally seeks no credit or claim, without doubt his help and support, both at the time and afterwards, has been critical to the families and the survivors. The leadership, the human dignity and courage shown by Kenny at that time is more inspiring than any goal scored or trophy won. And I think it serves as an example to us all. Today is significant because of the 25th anniversary. Occasions like this remind the country and the world of how important it is to remember and honour the people that we lost. Both for us, Liverpool Football Club and the city of Liverpool, we carry the memory every day, the 96 people, their families, the survivors. You matter to us every day, and that inspires us to play. So thank you for inviting me here. I really do feel inadequate in your company. But to be asked to do a reading at such a significant time in your battle, it's a huge honour, and I'm greatly humbled. And thank you for the inspiration you give to us all. The courage, the dignity, and all the most trying circumstances imaginable. We will always strive to honour you, the families, and the memory of the 96 people we lost. You'll never walk alone.
How did all this happen? Well, the families of the 96, we did it. Andy touched on it in his speech. We made it all happen. Against all the odds, we made it all happen. We stuck together, we pulled, we pushed, We refuse to lie down. We refuse to go away, which was something which annoyed an awful lot of people. And again, when any one of us was broken, the others rallied round, picked us up, helped us get back together again, onwards and upwards. In the words of John Bishop, we made all this happen. We, the families of the 96. It's not over yet, as Andy's already said, and there will be a great deal of heartache ahead for all of us. But we will get there, just as we've been here for 25 years. Families, we mourn our loved ones constantly, and especially today. But the spirit of the 96 burns in our hearts and drives us on.
It's good to welcome back to Anfield, Andy Burnham. So much. That felt better than last time. What an honour it is to stand before you again. 5 years ago, things changed. Not because of me, but because of you. All of you. Things changed because you were here again in your thousands, still at the side of these families after 20 dark years. And they changed because you made your voices heard, and thank God you did. That day your voices were carried off this cot and into every living room in the land, and from there into the heart of the establishment. I knew you were right and they were wrong. I wanted to address you today to thank you for that and for all the encouragement you have given to me since. Just as I did 5 years ago, I have asked people what else I should say to you today. My mum told me to wish you all the best for the league. To say how fitting it would be if you won it in this of all years. Now, Bill Kenwright said here last year that you've always got to do what a scout's mother tells you to do. But if I followed her advice today, my reception at Goodison tomorrow would be far worse than anything I've ever had here. So, ever the politician, I will just say that I can see what she means and leave it at that. I have many memories I have many memories of 5 years ago, but one stays with me, and I'll share it with you. When the service here was over, my great mate Steve Rotherham said to me, "You've got to come to the town hall to see the families get the freedom of the city." I said, "Steve, after the day I've had, I just think I'll get off home, mate." He said, no, you're coming, I insist." So off I went. I arrived at the town hall feeling a little bruised and fragile. As I trudged up the grand staircase, I looked up and the welcoming party would have struck fear into any Evertonian heart. Dalglish, Hanson, Gerard, Carragher. Just when I thought the day couldn't get any worse, Kenny boomed out at the top of his voice, "Oh no, Andy, you've not come to upset them all again, have you?" Famous sledgehammer wit, but it broke the ice and it brought us together that evening, and he helped me find a new resolve for you. And that's typical of the man. What leadership, what loyalty he has shown these 25 years. On your behalf, I thank him today. To ruin my childhood. And I thank all the players ever since, the current players here today, showing their respect. I thank the club as a whole. They've never let you down. And we thank others too today. The Right Reverend James Jones, who more than any before him, his position has brought peace and healing to this city. Professor Phil Scraton. Without whom, quite simply, the truth would never have been told. Jimmy McGovern. Tony Barrett. And my good friend David Conn, whose words were my trigger to act. I thank Maria Eagle, Steve Rotherham, Derek Twick, Alison McGovern for being there all the way with all of the Merseyside MPs. And today I thank the Home Secretary for her understanding and leadership. One other person, if you'll let me. 5 years ago, his shout was the first. So wherever you are out there, Roy Dixon, take a bow. If I live to be 100, I'm never going to forget the sound of your voice, mate, that's for sure. It was the moment the dam burst, but it had to. One lone cry, now an unstoppable movement, asking the most profound questions about our country and the way it has been run. How can it be that an entire city was crying injustice for 20 years and no one was listening? But the negatives are in the end outweighed. As things come full circle, the shadows are lifting. These last 25 years are a great vindication of your club, my club, our city, and everything it is about. A place that knows right from wrong, what true solidarity means. Liverpool stands before the country in a new light today, richer than others in what really matters. In time, your fight will make our country better, a place where power and respect are more evenly shared. I want to end by saying something directly to Margaret, to Sue, Trevor, Jenny, and all the families. And I only wish I could say it to Anne Williams, whose memory we also honour today. Matter more or bring a deeper sense of fulfillment. You have taught me more than a lifetime in politics ever could. Dignity, courage, humanity, you are truly the best of us. There is still an uncertain road ahead, we know that, but the country is with you now. It now knows the 96 better than it did before, and it knows them as your sons, daughters, fathers, cousins, all with their own hopes and dreams. We remember them all. We think of all of those hurt by Hillsborough, those lost souls and survivors who returned but were never the same. But they will prevail, and they'll prevail only because of all of you. So today is your day too. You have made this city stronger. You will make our country fairer. You have given hope to people the world over. And what was your call 5 years ago is mine today. Justice for the 96. Thank you very much.
When you walk through the snow.